Okay, so this is going to be a little bit odd. I'm doing a voice intro to a compilation because I didn't know how these missions were going to go, so I just dedicated to what works, which is music pumping in my ears and not worrying about commentary. So, as promised, here's the parts of it that I had problems with.
Careful, contractor. It looks like you've warped right into a minefield. This is where we lost contact with the malevolence. Judging by all the debris, I think we can guess what happened here. I've enabled a long wave using the emergency hailing frequencies. Let's see if there's anyone left alive on that thing.
Thank you.
buy them some more time while we get the ship back online. Online. Crew path to the minecraft. Nice work, contractor. Line up with the warp beacon and get back to base.
Two TLF destroyers have been tracked down in the Lazarus sector. The UTC destroyer Malevolence is back in service, and Captain Vandervector has prepared a trap for the TLF.
Stop. That's the last of them. Well done, contractor. Line up with the warp vector and head home.
Our intel has located the TLF research station that's producing those new heavy starfighters. It seems they're operating out of a mobile research station which is currently in the A51 sector. It will be your task to take out that research station and eliminate any TLF forces you find there. Our sensors have picked up a variety of warp disturbances coming from the sector, so you should be prepared for anything. It seems the TLF are interested in more than just developing bigger starfighters.
The TLF research station that produces those new heavy starfighters is just ahead. Destroy it along with any TLF forces you encounter. Be aware that the TLF have retrofitted that station with defensive weapon systems. Thank you.
And that is the last three missions of this game. So you may notice that I had a lot more control. This is because I built one of these, a Thrustmaster T-Flight Hot Ass 4 controller for PC, PlayStation 3 and PS4. And wow, that makes a lot of difference. I'm definitely looking forward to using it in Ace Combat, but we'll see how that goes later. But as I said, I'd come back with a video going through the last missions, and that is this. There's no credits, no nothing like that. You just got a little bit of a battle going in the background, one of my slip-ups, as to say. But yeah, with this sort of game, the controls make all the difference. Being able to use the hot-ass control just to control your throttle, so a Saint does a flyby, instantly drop down, turn, and do a power-up whilst through the turn, you can instantly get on their arse and send a couple of missiles up their tailpipe, which is very handy. So, yeah, I'm going to see if I can find more games that I can use the hot-ass for. I might start doing Elite Dangerous, but that doesn't really have a campaign, so I'm not sure. That could end up being a stream, I don't know. But yeah, so this is where I'm going to leave this. End Space is actually complete, and we'll have something new starting on Wednesday. Thanks for bearing with me, and have a good one.